Guy and I love period movies because we feel that it allows us to create a world where you can have a heightened sensibility and a fun tone and still suspend the audience's disbelief. So we've created, hopefully, an unreal world that feels real. Our Napoleon Solo does have, on the surface, very similar characteristics to Napoleon Solo in the television series, in that he is he's the man with the gift of the gab. He's very smooth, he's a ladies' man, he's a man who's able to improvise and make the best out of difficult situations, and he's very casual and smooth and cool. Kuryakin was always the strong, silent, handsome type. He was the blonde Russian, and we have a little bit of that with Army. Same sort of thing. He's more silent, he's less verbal, he's less quick-witted perhaps, but he has his own particular strength. He's physically very strong, and he's got that sort of strong, silent toughness to him, and a sort of a more primitive, if you like, primal attraction, which makes him very different, and I think a good combination. Really, Henry, who we've been a fan of since the Tudors, seemed like the obvious first choice for a Napoleon Solo, and Army, likewise, who we've been a fan of from The Social Network, felt like the right person for Kuryakin. So there wasn't really, they just felt right. It was, obviously, we did our due diligence and we went through various lists, as one always does. But they were far and away our first choices for those two characters. We were fans of Alicia's from A Royal Affair. She was so spectacular in that film. And we wanted a European girl, we wanted somebody who could play a German girl, and somebody who had that fantastic mixture of sort of youth and naivety, but real intelligence and real strength that she brings to the table. Elizabeth Debicki, she was so phenomenal in Gatsby, and we both felt really stood out in a fantastic cast, that again, she was, when her name came up, she felt like a sort of inspired and obvious choice. She then did a reading, and she was sensational. Her hair was blonde, and which it is naturally, and she reminded us of a young Catherine Deneuve, which was sort of perfect for that period. And again, once we saw her, we thought, wow, she's definitely the one. I think one of the best and most interesting things about what Guy does as a director is that he's confident enough to come there on the day and be open enough to take the time to actually go, wait, can we make this better now? We've got this, it's good, but what can we do to make it even better? What can we do to make it great? And I think very often he comes up with really, really cool stuff on the day. And occasionally I do too.